What's up, Jabroni? Steven here, and welcome back to another Cobra Kai reaction. We are on episode number 6 today, and in the last episode, like I mentioned in my posts, my review of last episode, and at the ending of the episode, I talked about last episode had the biggest highs, I think, of the series so far, the lunchroom fight, as well as the Mr. Miyagi part of the episode. I thought those were like the two biggest highs of the show. The rest of the episode was kind of okay, but those were the two biggest highs. We learned in the last episode that Aisha, which is Sam's friend, which I kept calling her Claire for some reason, but her name's Sam, Danny's daughter. We learned that she's up there joining Cobra Kai, as well as a bunch of other students have showed up because of that lunchroom brawl to learn some karate. We also learned, what else did we learn? We learned that Johnny's kid is joining the LaRusso Auto family just to spite his father. We'll see how that turns into anything. Danny tried to end Johnny's business by getting the owner to rise up the prices and stuff, so Danny's not being Danny, and that's why the Mr. Miyagi part happened, and that's why the ending of the episode we saw Danny getting back into his like karate. But yeah, this episode is called Quiver. Not sure what that means. Quiver, it could mean that they're scared. I mean, I don't know. I'm assuming this episode will be a lot with the son and something happening with the students at Cobra Kai because it's Johnny. I don't think he's going to be all for that stuff. We'll find out though. Pretty much, ladies and gentlemen, let's hop into the episode. Hopefully you guys have been enjoying the series. If you have, make sure you guys hit the thumbs up. You guys hit the little notification bell. Subscribe to the channel as always. Hopefully you guys enjoy this. Here we go. Quiver, tremble or shake with a slight rapid motion. Oh, okay. Makes sense. So it was kind of like what I thought. Just the fear part of it. Cobra's got it. All right, well, we start off with some banger music. What do we got today? Looks like we're doing a flashback today. Is that Johnny? Is Johnny for money? This is awesome. We're getting to know more about Johnny's backstory. Karate, the original Cobra Kai. Very cool. I don't know. Let's see how he handles all these students, because I'm thinking not very well.
Shirt.
Thanks.
I'm joking, it sucks.
What an asshole.
Word of advice, if you got shit for teeth, don't smile.
Damn, why is he being so fucking mean?
God, makes me feel like a virgin just looking at you.
Yeah! Yeah! I mean, some of them gotta be decent, yeah! Right? Some, maybe a couple.
Okay, stand straight, plant your feet in there. Yeah! Are you sure you're right-handed?
Yeah! He said, are you sure you're right-handed? Yeah!
You got weight, use it.
Yeah. Yeah, thick skin to take some of this guy's insults.
All right, you hear that lip? If you can't handle someone making fun of you, how are you gonna handle an elbow to the teeth?
By calling the police?
Dude, knock it off.
What? He does realize the Nazis lost the war, right? Why should I be scared of him? Because he's got a snake on his wall? It's not like he's a teacher who can give us a bad grade. We're paying him. He works for us. It's not like he can actually hurt us.
Hit me. Go ahead, hit me. Strike me right here. Harder.
Just don't break any bones.
Is that all you got, princess?
Miguel's interesting. That's what I'm trying to teach you.
Let that be a lesson to all of you.
Yeah, but you can't quit. I got yelled at, got my ass kicked, and then gave him my money. You know who lives like that? Hookers.
Yeah, but he's not that bad of a guy. You gotta give him a chance.
This is awesome.
You don't know him like I do. Oh, that's hooker talk. Besides, I don't need to learn karate when I have you.
Hey, how's the new kid working out?
Oh, great. We had a bunch of pain in the ass stuff piled up for weeks. Inventory, sticker swaps. Kid knocked most of it out before lunch.
So you're saying I should fire you and give him your job?
Oh, that new kid. No, he's terrible. Very unmotivated. You gotta keep explaining stuff to him. I'm pretty sure he's got a head injury.
He's like, oh my gosh, he touched me.
I'm gonna go grab a chair.
Yeah, no problem.
He's sniffing his shirt. Did they set him up? Oh, they set him up. Come on, really?
What the hell's the matter with you? Starting a car in a crowded showroom? What are you, out of your mind? What were you thinking?
Not to fire me, okay, I quit.
Hey, Robbie, it's Robbie, right? Come here, right? It's Robbie, you're gonna break your thumb there.
What?
Make a fist. Make a fist. If you're gonna punch your boss, you gotta make a tight fist. Thumb around the outside, underneath. Squeeze the knuckles, extend the hand straight out. You see that? All right, come on. Let it fly. Hit my hand. Okay. All right.
You have to hit him so hard.
That's better.
I think he's gonna like it. Oh, that's nasty. I remember doing that in high school.
What were you thinking for sex? In the male, this tract opens up near the umbilical cord. So I think ours is female.
Yeah, I concur.
He's so nervous.
No, no, no. Lip has something he wants to say.
Come on, show some boss.
Speak up, Lip.
Show some boss.
Your tongue messed up too. Are you one of those challenge kids?
The doctor said I could be on the spectrum.
I don't know what that is, but get off it pronto. All right? If you don't want me to call you Lip, then don't have a weird lip. Can't you get surgery for that?
I was born with a cleft lip. This is the scar from the surgery.
You mean it was worse before that? Or did the doctor just screw up? Because if this is the after photo, then that sucks, man. You should sue.
Can we just please change the topic?
You don't think I want to? It's tough when it's right in front of
me. Don't be a
if
dick, though, man. Damn.
The scar on his lip, then you got to flip the script, okay? Like get a face tattoo or gouge your eye out. We'll call you Patch, all right? No, don't do that. You'll still look like a freak.
Damn, why you gotta be such an asshole, man?
Oh, great. Really? Another quitter?
Oh, the cassette tape from when he was little. Ooh, we're gonna get flashbacks probably of when he tried to be it and then he got made fun of or something, I'm guessing. Sorry, guys. I got my coffee on the side.
Kick, like, all the way above their heads. I mean, if I get those lessons, then I could totally get it above my head.
That's great, sweetie.
Oh, yeah, his mom. And they had this snake, and it had these huge fangs, and it was just so cool. Oh, yeah, they also had these headbands, and it was so badass. They didn't get the lessons, right, Mom?
Besides, don't you get in enough fights already at school?
Sid.
What? Look, the kid's a social reject. He doesn't have a single friend.
Well, maybe this is how he can make some friends.
Make some friends. So, you want to be the next Bruce Lee, huh? First it was a drum set, then it was the roller skates. Whatever happened to the magic kit? You were going to be Doug Henning.
He's 12 years old. They go through phases. They try new things.
Okay, fine. I'll write the goddamn check. I'll make it out to garbage because that's where it's going to end up.
Seriously.
What seriously?
Just
what?
Just don't tonight, please.
Tonight? What are you talking about? Every night I come home and I... I just
come home one night.
Sucks that his parents are, I mean, his dad was such an asshole. Sure knocks.
Hey, Robbie.
Did you sense that I was here?
Oh.
The mirror.
Reflection.
Here's a sales report you asked for.
Sales report? Yeah, this is good stuff. Very important, dude. You didn't share this with anyone else, did you?
Yeah, no, sir. Your eyes only.
That's good. We won't want this sensitive material to fall into the wrong hands, now would we?
Damn it, Luke.
One's on you, pal.
He got clowned
next
again.
Next time, you outsmart the dope.
Yeah. Fool me once, right? At a karate, you were doing worse than punching.
Oh, karate isn't all punching and kicking. It's actually more about balance.
And that didn't even really look like karate.
Well, blueprints don't actually look like cars either, do they?
What do you mean?
That was kata,
That's the foundation of my karate.
It's cool.
Or if more people drop the class and you're making less money because you're such a moron.
3 more absences, sensei.
Bunch of pussies.
Dear Jesus, Aisha.
No, it's my fault.
Since you joined Cobra Kai, I have been hard on you. I've called you names. I've humiliated you. Some of you I've hit. And for that,
I'm sorry.
I don't apologize.
Oh, damn, okay.
Just like a cobra, I had to shed my loser skin to find my true power. And you guys will too. Welcome to Cobra Kai.
Eli, what happened?
Okay.
I'm flipping the scripts.
Respect.
Wait, you the kid with the lip? Nice cut, bro. You see that?
Respect.
Doesn't matter if you're a loser, or a nerd, or a freak. All that matters is that you become badass. Hawk.
See, now you're caught Hawk. Yeah. Flip the script. Good shit, though, dude. I'm worried about him.
Does not exist in this dojo, does it?
No, sensei.
Pain does not exist in this dojo, does it?
No, sensei.
Defeat does not exist in this dojo, does it?
No, sensei.
Class, are you ready to learn the way of the fist?
Yes, sensei!
Ooh. I am curious where this is all gonna go. Well, that was episode number 6, I believe. I can't remember what episode that was, but I think it was number 6. It was called Quiver. Actually, it was an episode about breaking people down and building them back up. That's not Johnny's intentions, but that's what ended up happening. Johnny was a dick to a bunch of kids. A lot of them left. Some of them changed, and Johnny was an asshole. But the episode, we did get to see Miguel and Samantha. Got her name right. They're starting to get closer. We saw that Johnny's kid, which I can't remember his name, is getting closer to Danny. That's awesome. We get to see a little bit more of an origin story of where Johnny came from. Johnny did come from money, but he had an asshole father, and he had trouble in school, and we get to learn more about Johnny, and that's something I love because it helps feed into the original movie, which I love so much. So I definitely appreciate that. It's going to be interesting to see where things go, because at the end of this episode, we saw the kid with the lip. I forgot what his name is, but he kept calling him Lip, making fun of him. He told him to switch the script, and he came back with a badass mohawk looking all mean. I've got this weird indication that Johnny is going to turn these guys into a bunch of fucking killers, and it's going to turn really bad. But I enjoyed the episode. This one was a lot more mellow. We got to learn about Robbie. I have this thing about Robbie where I think he's liking the job. I think he's liking Danny because Danny's like this father figure he never had, and his dad's such a like a bad. He's a rough. He's too rough, and Danny's more like a sweet guy. So I like that dynamic, and also like Danny's cousin or whatever brother-in-law making fun of like kind of clowning Robbie. Oh yeah, his name's Robbie. So I don't know. Again, show's going strong. I'm enjoying it. I like where it's going to go. The next episode where I think is everything's going to go, we're going to get more with the kids. I think we're going to get more of that Miguel, Samantha dynamic. I really like their dynamic. I like how they're getting closer. She keeps getting bullied, which sucks, but I'm hoping that they are able to balance each other out really well and they fit well, because the last thing we saw, he sent her like a little text thing or something on the internet, and it was cute. I liked it. So I'm enjoying the series, and I definitely can't wait to keep watching more. Hopefully you're enjoying the series as well. If you are, hit the like button, hit the subscribe button. You know the deal. And pretty much, I'll talk to you guys later. Peace.